Welcome to the Mount Enon Church. This is Pastor Corey J. Pruitt. We're welcoming you to share with us at 1501 West 3rd Street or search out our website at www.mountenonbaptistlive.org. Join us for our services live on Facebook. 8:30 a.m. is our Sunday school. 9:30 a.m. is our corporate time of prayer and intercession. 10 o'clock a.m. is our worship service. Wednesdays, 11 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. are Bible studies. Don't forget our exciting Saturday Bible study at 11 a.m. Join us as Mount Enon in 2019. We're turning back to God. We're turning back our focus, our fellowship, and our fruitfulness. They're all tied to God. We look forward to having you and your family join us here.
We invite you to join us every day on the prayer line at 7 a.m. and 9 p.m. Just dial 937-265-4344, extension 101. Then enter code 502-801-253, pound.
Will you pray with me? Our God, our strength, our Lord, we are determined to please you today. And right now we ask that you'll allow our faith to be increased, for we understand that it is by faith that you are pleased. Father God, allow us now to regard in our hearts the love that you've shared with us. Father God, we ask now that you'd please allow us to see that worry is unacceptable. And right now, that person that's in a bad place, in a difficult time, God, we ask that you'd send angels right now to rescue them as they are seemingly sinking. But God, I pray that you'll allow your angels to hold their heads above the water. It's in Jesus' name that we do ask these things. Amen.
Now, faith is the substance of things. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Now faith
is the substance of things hoped for. Do you all have just a moment? Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Come here, man. Yeah. Get one of them the baby right there for a second. I'm gonna need you to help me just one moment. Faith, I'm gonna pay him good for this. I'm gonna pay him good for this, all right? Faith is the substance of things hoped for, but it's the evidence of those things not seen. For by it, the elders obtained a good report. In other words, everybody that came before him that operated like this became known and well known as a result. Because if you keep on reading, you're going to see that Abel by faith conquered his mission. Abraham by faith conquered his mission. Are you with me here? But then 2 Corinthians, if you would, at about 5 and about verse 7 says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Now, one thing you got to realize and recognize is that he has to totally lean and depend on me. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. I know that there are those of you who watch the Bird Box movie. And if you haven't, I want you to watch it after this service. If you will, I want to ask you today, how are you walking? I'm going to pay you real good if you just stick with me. Text goes on in 2 Corinthians, if you will, and declares at chapter 10. At verse 4 and says, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of that's, come on, not seen. See, because when you're warring, guess what? You're warring spiritually. Your spiritual battle is a battle with those that you cannot. Oh, God, help me, man. I can close right there. Because the saints of God need be aware that everybody in this room needs a bird box. Write that down someplace. I said, everybody in this room needs a bird box. Write that down. I'm going to help you in just a moment. I want to ask you the question, how are you walking? Stay with me. Watch this. So many people today have witnessed this movie. Sandra Bullock comes up with the idea, if you will, that a mysterious force decimates the population. And the only one thing that's certain, that if you see it, you're actually going to die. But the survivors must now avoid coming face to face with an entity that takes the form of their worst fears. Are y'all gonna help me here? You do know that the opposite of faith is fear. In fact, if faith were in reverse, come on, you would literally experience, come on, fear. Your faith in a snake is your fear in a snake is your faith in a snake that it can destroy you. Are y'all listening here? It's imperative, it's important today that we understand and acknowledge with our spiritual senses that God has called us to be a faithful people. In fact, there are those of you who've perused 2018 with your eyes wide open. In fact, you've done everything according to the way that you felt that it should have been done. But because of your faithlessness, you've missed many miracles that God wanted to perform because you were so in charge of your life this year that you've gained the elements of self-worth. However, you've not grown spiritually to see that God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think. And here's the reality. If we as the saints of God would begin to really become faithful entities, we would then begin to trust God when we can't trace him. In fact, there are those of us who would be so solidly placed spiritually that we'd find ourselves in a place that we did not have to see everything before it took place because we knew that God already had a handle on the situation. And I'm here to tell you, the only reason why I showed back up to this pulpit is because I came up here blind and blindfolded, not knowing what God would do from Sunday to Sunday. I didn't know how he would provide financially and all of the above. But here's what happens. It's simply because when God places you in a place, God does not expect that you be God. God does not want you to be God. God says, I want you to totally trust and depend on me. And I know that some of you don't understand this because you're so used to being in charge. You are so spiritually independent. And I know that you found yourself in a place where you have to dictate to whatever goes on around you. But I'm trying to tell you that faith, watch this, faith causes one to lose the ability to control the environment, and you have to subjugate yourself to the unknown and sometimes what seems to be unnecessary. I came to preach this morning. Y'all ain't here yet. But here's what happens. If you find yourself in unnecessary places, just stick around long enough to see what God is going to do when he takes you through the storm. Just stick around long enough to see that when you get done crying, what God has taught your heart to endure. Is there anybody here that's been through hell this year and you've determined that those tears were tears of joy, and now that I've learned what I've learned, I'm better because of the hell that I encountered? Can you tell somebody right now, you're looking at one who has grown in God. You may have saw me going through some places that were undesirable and seemingly unnecessary, but God took me through that because he knew that he was building on me. Is there anybody here that knows that God is building on you? If you don't mind, just give somebody a high five and say, neighbor, look at the architecture. Look at what God has made me to be, because there was a time where I would have stopped coming to church. I would have stopped giving my hands up to God. I would have stopped clapping. I would have stopped listening to the sermonic presentation. But because God has a plan for my life, I don't care who's preaching it. I don't care who's declaring it. But if somebody's got a word from God, I want to hear it. Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbor, I've got a word in my belly. There's something that God's trying to get through to me, and I'm trying to walk in favor. And one thing you realize in this movie, those of you who watched it, you're going to see several theological lessons. Because one thing you'll see is the blindfolded element is the element, come on, of faith. I just explained that because we see that faith is the substance of things hoped for, but it's the actual evidence of what we reach for. Does that make sense? You'll see also the lesson, if you please, of tough love and parenting. Because when you look at it, I can remember a scene where the little girl was tied up. She was told, don't get out of the boat. Whatever you do, don't get out of the boat. No matter what you hear, don't get out of the boat. And the little girl, watch this, as soon as she heard voices, one good thing is, come on, she began to walk, but she never took off her blindfold. Y'all quiet. The script says to train up a child in the way that he should go. And when he is old, come on, he will keep on his blindfold. Oh, y'all don't like this kind of preaching. Faith says that if we're going to solidify a spiritual strength and a life of stability, we as the saints of God are going to have to hold strong and fast to our faith. This means that you're going to have to literally be vulnerable to an environment, watch this, that is so unknown. This environment is so tricky sometimes because sometimes you're up and sometimes you're down. Are you with me here? And not just that, you'll see the lessons of life as they traveled on a river. Come on, talk to me, somebody. Some of those moments on the river were calm. Y'all gonna help me? Some of those moments on the river were rocky. Some ups and downs. I mean, it's the very essence of life as we know it, as Christians. Can you say amen to that? But this lesson, if you will, is significant because the woman that is leading and guiding these babies to their destiny has found herself in a place where she says, I've got to live. I cannot die because of these two souls that I have connected to me. Is there anybody here that's got some souls connected to you and that's the reason why you're still afloat right now? You're still floating because you can't allow your children to see you fold in the midst of your storms. You're still floating because your haters are standing by waiting on your demise. Is there anybody here that can declare, I can't fold right now because, listen, God has something for me on the other side of the river, hey, that I've got to get to. Is there anybody that knows that on the other side of the river, I sing it all the time, Jesus, keep me near the cross. Y'all ain't saying it here. He says, I'm going to watch it. Wait, he says that this glory that we're looking for is just beyond. Man, if you can make it through the river, if you can make it through the challenges of the river, you can get to your destiny. And I want to challenge you today to see that this theological expression is significant. This woman goes on a dangerous journey through the woods, down the river, to find this place that may offer, come on, some serenity, some sanctuary. Are you with me here? And I've discovered that this story unfolds many historical values of biblical texts. And I want to focus in on the action that was taken because this woman, in the face of evil lurking, chooses to go on a journey. That's what's happening to those of us who are Christians. We need to understand that, guess what? When you walk out into choir rehearsal, you're walking out on a journey where evil is lurking. When you choose to be an usher on the usher's ministry, I got news for you. Every time you stand up, you're standing up in the middle of evil. Come on, evil is lurking. But because you take the challenge on to show back up on next Sunday, you've literally gotten in your spiritual boat to ride that rough river. Because some people some days have good days. Some people some days will cuss you out. Even at Mount Enon. Some days people will look at you strange. Some days people are in their bipolar spirituality. They want to deal with you sometimes and sometimes they don't. Sometimes people are in their spiritual candy bar. Sometimes you feel like a nut and sometimes you don't. Almond Joy has got nuts. I mean, sometimes people are just tricky. But when you're solidly placed in God and you've taken on the challenge to do what God says, sometimes you have to come to a crowd that won't even say amen. But you have to keep on pressing to paint a picture, if you will, of those who experience this evil lurking on the other side of their force. Are you with me here? One thing you must see is that there's an example of the narrow road concept, and it's visible here. Matthew 7:13 says, enter through the narrow gate, for the wide gate and broad. Are you with me here? The wide gate. And broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. Now, you must understand that as they began to fight this fight, the crowd begins to become smaller because other people are giving up on the race. Man, I wish I had watched the movie. Many people are giving up on the race, and sometimes you're going to feel like you're on this journey by yourself. Oh, but I'm trying to tell you right now that when you got God and you got that blindfold on and you got the bird box. See, one thing you got to realize is that the blindfold element represents, come on, the faith. The waters represent the elements of life. But that bird box represents, y'all ought to help me here, the pneumatological, though it's eschatological in its whole, but it represents the pneumatological expressions of God. In fact, here's what happens. You do know that it was the Holy Spirit, the one who made everybody aware. He was the unheard voice or this unseen person that made the people of God aware of what was going on around them. Ah. He was the voice, because one thing you'll discover on this movie is that these birds recognize the presence of evil. Reason why some of y'all got a boo right now that don't belong to you is because you didn't have a bird box. Some have endured and encountered unnecessary experiences in your life because you were trying to please somebody that wasn't even interested in you anyway. But if you had the bird box, as soon as that no good rascal came, the alert would have been immediate. Y'all ain't sitting here. Some of us have the Holy Ghost in our lives, but we ignore his messages. Don't look at me in that tone of voice. I mean, if somebody came up there fine as wine, sexy as can be, but the bird box is going off, and you still yet trying to deal with the elements of the beauty that you see when the Holy Ghost is saying, hey, that ain't the one, that ain't the one, that ain't the one. Lord, give me John. Lord, give me John. That ain't the one, that ain't the one. Here's the bird box constantly going out, and you're looking around trying to figure out how you get in this hell you got in. It's because you've ignored the messages of he, the Holy Spirit. Look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, everybody needs a bird box. Everybody needs a bird box. Because he shows us when the enemy is lurking. Now, you got to listen to your bird box, because sometimes other people's bird boxes go off in their lives and they ain't even listening themselves. They've had all kinds of crazy instances in their lives, and God told them the one you got now ain't yours. Y'all ain't sitting here, and they still trying to talk about other people. Make sure that your bird box is an intimate connection with the Almighty God. And not only that, but that bird box, watch this, is also an intricate detail, because that bird box represents the elements of discernment. One of the reasons why we're in the shape that we're in is because many of us don't have discernment. Now, discernment works both ways. Discernment don't just tell you when I'm low down. Discernment works both ways. See, but discernment says, I know my own problems. Come on, before I go and tell somebody about theirs. Y'all gonna help me here? In fact, if we continue to watch, you're gonna discover that this woman's vow to do what the Bible says concerning children. Again, she says, train up a child in the way it should go. Are you with me here? And she's going to have experiences with growth in areas of wisdom and prudent maturation. They will take, what they've learned, and they're going to use it. You agree with that? Now, the woman was the main character on the river. Are you with me here? She and these babies, and the river is full of obstacles. Can you say amen to that? The river is full of uncertainty. Can you say amen to that? The river is full of powers lurking to destroy. Can you say amen to that? The river has those unknown and those unhelpful voices. Can you say amen to that? There are those of us who have employed unhelpful voices in our spirits. That one that tells, see something now. Watch this. You must understand that everything is not for everybody. Write that down someplace. I said, please write that down. Everything is not for everybody. Because some people, you will see them wear certain things and you'd be like, who told her to put that on? See, the reason why y'all laughing, y'all already know what I'm talking about. You've talked about people. You're like, Lord, where is she going with that on? That was that voice that made a fool out of you to make you believe. Y'all ain't standing here. You're not what you used to be. Don't allow the unknown voices to speak to you to make a fool out of you. Can you say amen to that? The river, that has those unknown and helpful voices. The river is equivalent to life. I told you that. And not just life, but the life of those faithful believers who've chosen to live under the auspices of God and have been instructed that we should walk by faith and not by sight. When you're riding on this river, you got to realize that this is your spiritual walk. You must hang in there regardless of what the enemy throws your way. I say you got to hang in there regardless of what the enemy throws your way. Mount Enon, I'm here to tell you that if you don't hear anything else that I tell you right today, you must understand that you got to hang in there regardless of what the enemy throws your way. I need you to help me to preach this to somebody. Extend yourself, watch this, and tell somebody you got to hang in there. Y'all ain't helping me. I said, look at somebody and tell them you got to hang in there regardless of what life throws your way. Come on, tell somebody else around you. Tell them, hang in there, regardless of what the sickness may be. Tell them, hang in there, regardless of how your account may become low. Come on, tell them, hang in there, regardless of how people may talk about you. Tell them to hang in there. It might get dark sometime, but you just keep on going in the name of the Lord. Tell them, hang in there, though it may seem like God has left you by yourself, but you hang in there because God has got his hands on you. It's at your worst moments that God is doing something great in your life. Can you help me to tell somebody, hang in there? In fact, don't you just tell them to hang in there. You said, don't you dare give up. Adam messed around and gained sight in the beginning of the text. And as a result of the whole world, watch this, the whole world received death. Some things God does not want us to see. Look at Adam. I said Adam messed up and he found his place, himself in a place, come on, where he had sight. Are you listening? His eyes was open. Then God asked him, he says, well, who told you that you were naked? Because now the blindfold has been moved because we failed to trust in God. I know y'all don't like this kind of preaching. We fail to trust in the fact that God is able to handle it even when we seem like we can't make it. I'm preaching better than y'all shouting. Are you with me? But one thing you must realize is that though Adam messed up, it's my pleasure to announce to you today that before the foundation of the world, there was a lamb already slain. See, you got to understand that God knew that the blindfold would come off. Oh, yeah. God knew that Adam would become so uncomfortable. Y'all real quiet. Come here, man. Watch this. I'm going to blindfold him again. You okay? Not too tight, is it? All right. I'm going to blindfold him again. But man, I'm going to tell you right now, he was a lot more comfortable when his eyes was open. He was a lot more tranquil when his eyes were open. Now that he has to subjugate his will to my will, y'all ain't saying nothing. He has become a little bit more, come on, he's become a little bit more clingy because he does not know where he's going. Watch that organ. Don't run into it. Watch it. There goes some snakes. Watch out. He can't see anything. He has to trust in my voice. He can't see nothing. He has to trust in the fact that I'm going to lead him in a way that's not going to be harmful for him.
If you need additional information concerning any of these events, please contact our church office at 937-222-0867. And remember, because we care, we share. And have a